Hi guys, Story Recaps here. Today, I am going to explain a 2021 American action comedy film titled as Red Notice. Spoilers ahead, watch out and take care. A story about Cleopatra and Mark Antony opens the film. He gave her 3 bejeweled eggs as a token of his unending passion on their wedding day. For generations, the eggs were thought to be nothing more than legends. However, 2 of them were discovered by a local farmer in Cairo in 1907. The 3rd egg, on the other hand, was never discovered. In the current day, FBI criminal profiler Special Agent John Hartley and Interpol Agent Doss arrive at a museum in Rome after receiving information from his trusted source, the bishop, that one of the museum's eggs is about to be stolen. The egg is still in place and unbroken when it arrives in the display room. Hartley uses a thermal sensor to scan the 18-karat gold egg and discovers that it does not reflect the heat in the room, indicating that it is a fake egg. He gets a Coke from a visitor and pours it into the egg to illustrate his idea. International art thief Nolan Booth reveals himself and manages to exit the room as Doss orders the guard to close the chamber quickly. The guards pursue him, but he defeats them all by dismantling the scaffolding and causing it to fall, allowing him to reach the upper floor of the room. Hartley, on the other hand, enters and corners Booth. They get into a quarrel, which results in both of them falling out of a window. Booth is able to slip down a pipe and escape on a stolen motorcycle. Hartley tries to catch up with him in a super fancy sports vehicle, but he's a lousy driver and is T-boned by a gelato truck right away. Booth returns at his refuge in Bali 56 hours after the crime with the egg in his possession. Hartley, on the other hand, has been waiting for him and dispatches Interpol officers to apprehend him and seize the egg. Hartley explains that the bishop sells Booth out and tells the FBI agent where the hideout is. While Hartley is loading the egg into the truck, the bishop, disguised as one of the team members, replaces the real egg with a fake one. Hartley is approached by Doss on the day he prepares to depart Rome in an hour. She displays the phony egg and tosses it to the floor, accusing Hartley of switching the egg. She also mentions that a $8 million wire transfer was recently made to a Swiss bank account in Hartley's name. Despite Hartley's pleadings and repeated claims that he is innocent, he is arrested and deported to Russia. When Hartley discovers that Booth is his cellmate, things get even worse. Both of them believe Hartley was set up by the bishop while dining. Hartley claims to have eliminated her main adversary, Booth, as well as the chief investigator, himself, in a single move, or 2 birds, 1 egg, as Booth puts it. The bishop's intention to collect all of Cleopatra's eggs is revealed by the famed art thief and sell them for $300 million to an Egyptian billionaire on the eve of his daughter's wedding. They also know that the 2nd egg is currently in the possession of Sotto Voce, an international armaments dealer, and is kept in a secret vault inside his home. Only by breaking into the vault during one of his annual parties is it possible to steal it. Booth then announces to the entire cafeteria that Hartley is not a cop and that he is an FBI agent a few moments later. Because the inmates despise cops and aren't stupid, one of them, Drago Grand, approaches them and challenges Hartley. Despite his assurances that he doesn't want any problems, Drago throws a punch, forcing the guards to respond and return them to the cell. After a short time, Hartley and Booth are taken before the bishop, who claims to be the prison's captain. She admits that she was the one who switched the egg and wired the money to a Hartley-owned account. She assures them she'll steal the 2nd egg in less than 48 hours and tells Hartley that Booth knows where the last egg is hidden. She offers him 10% of the money and promises to let him free if he reveals the location of the egg, but he refuses to reveal anything. They decide to join forces and begin devising their escape strategy. Before going to sleep, we learn that Booth is the son of a Swiss police captain, and that his father was a jerk who falsely accused him of stealing his watch. For a year, his father refused to speak to him until he uncovered the truth behind some paperwork. They carry out their escape plan the next day. Booth starts by injecting nitroglycerin into a machine, which causes it to explode. Using a key card that Booth grabbed from a security guard when Drago attacked Hartley, they manage to flee the building in the subsequent commotion. While Hartley is distracting the guards, Booth makes it onto the chopper. Hartley tries to sprint towards the chopper, but a guard shoots a missile at him, collapsing the bridge. Fortunately, just as Booth is about to take off, he manages to climb up and aboard the chopper. The guard tries to fire another missile, but Hartley opens the other door, forcing the missile to fly through the chopper and crash into a mountain instead. In London, the bishop holds an agent imprisoned in his office while sending a message to Das via his computer, notifying her that Hartley and Booth have escaped from the prison. She also sends an invitation to the party hosted by sotto voce. Booth, on the other hand, summons his friend Tambwe to pick him and Hartley up and fly them to sotto voce's mansion. While Hartley is examining the house's design, Booth reveals his idea to exploit a hidden entry to gain access to Voce's safe, which is located upstairs and closely secured. Furthermore, all actions in the house are watched by CCTVs that are already equipped with cutting-edge technology. He also mentions that the sole way into the vault is by facial and speech recognition, which Booth is prepared for with his own face and voice replacement technology. Finally, they must input a 12-digit passcode that can only be discovered on sotto voce's phone and which requires fingerprint confirmation. To cut a long story short, they arrive at the masquerade party. When Hartley meets Bishop, he asks her for a dance, which isn't on the agenda. Sotto Hartley is spotted dancing with the most attractive female at the party, making Voce envious. He asks her to dance with him respectfully. Booth, on the other hand, collects his fingerprints and Hartley manages to steal the phone before heading to the vault room. Booth manages to hack the CCTV and gain access to the vault. They break the glass containing Voce's fingerprint, but they are able to recover the fingerprint and proceed to unlock the door. Das enters just as they are about to enter, brandishing her gun at them. She directs Hartley to arrest Booth in order to establish his innocence. He refuses and enters the vault alongside Booth. Unfortunately, Bishop has already gained access to the building and is fighting them for the egg. A long battle, while sotto voce and his men enter the vault, she manages to outskill both of them. Bishop, to his surprise, had organized this with him, notifying him that Hartley and Booth would be arriving for the egg. The men at Voce then knock them out. Hartley will be shocked with electric cables unless Booth tells them where the third egg is hidden. Even after Bishop has boosted the voltage to maximum, he still refuses to speak. Voce loses patience and strangles Hartley, revealing the location of the last egg, which is hidden in a pyramid in Cairo. Bishop poisons sotto voce's drink just before they leave, causing him to pass out. Voce awakens, but his vision is compromised, and he begins firing indiscriminately at Hartley and Booth as the woman walks away. The bullet strikes the cuff thanks to Voce, and Hartley is able to free himself and flee with Booth. They make it out of the subway, only to find themselves in the middle of a bullfight. To cut a long story short, the men board a train, where Booth explains that he lied about the location of the last egg. He is, however, adamant about not telling Hartley. Hartley almost pushes him off the train before giving in and pulling him back in. Hartley's father was a con artist who is now a cop, while Booth's father was a cop who is now a crook. They decide to aid one other because of their similarity. The third egg was buried by Rudolf Zeich, Hitler's personal antiquities dealer, and was shipped to Argentina along with all the stolen Nazi valuables, according to Booth. He soon discovered that the watch's father cherished contained the coordinates for the bunker where the egg was stored. They arrive at the bunker's precise location, which is in the middle of the forest. However, Booth realizes that he has been reading the map backwards the entire time, which enrages Hartley. When he destroys the compass, they realize they're standing on top of it and begin digging, where they discover a path leading to a massive vault filled with stolen items. They finally uncover the final egg after investigating the vault, but Bishop appears, along with Das and her gang, who had been following Bishop. While being pursued by Interpol agents, they attempt to flee in an old Mercedes automobile. The criminals are able to steal the Interpol agent's vehicle, leaving Das alone. The three then drive out of the cave and freefall over a waterfall in their automobile. Booth secures the egg and swims away, but he is unable to locate Hartley. He drops the egg and tries to save him by jumping back into the water, but he is okay. Hartley learns that Booth genuinely cares about him. Bishop survives the collision not long after, and as Hartley appears to be preparing to arrest her, they kiss instead. It turns out that Hartley had been collaborating with Bishop all along. They're a couple who've been plotting the egg theft since the beginning and have enlisted Booth's help in finding the third egg. She also explains that the electrocution scenario was staged in order for the cuff's key to be passed. Booth is compelled to hand over the egg and is handcuffed to a tree. The couple travels to Cairo for the wedding of the billionaire's daughter. He gives the bride the three Cleopatra's eggs as a wedding gift. Ed Sheeran unexpectedly shows up to the party and performs a spectacular musical performance. Das and Interpol agents appear out of nowhere and arrest the wealthy. Ed is also detained for attempting to attack the guards. The eggs are secured by Interpol officials, but Hartley and Bishop escape unobserved with $300 million in their bank account. The couple is on a boating vacation at the end of the film when Booth approaches them. He was apprehended by Doss but managed to flee. He informs them that he informed Doss about their bank account where the $300 million was moved, and she immediately blocked the funds. He then offers them the option of working together on another crime or being arrested because Interpol agents are approaching the yacht. The couple reluctantly consents and flees. When Doss gets back to the office, he sends a red notice to all three thieves. They arrive in Paris on the other hand, ready to carry out their next heist, the Louvre. Subscribe and turn on the notifications. We daily upload videos like this.